Snestruck.
If you like puzzle platformers like The Lost Vikings, then you'd enjoy Tsutehakun, a Super Famicom game that never left Japan. It recently received an English patch a few months ago, but this isn't a game that requires one. You can play it as is. It's one of those games that's reasonably easy to play, but can be very difficult to master. You play as this transparent bird thing, I guess? It has a beak that absorbs or injects color into transparent objects, and each color has a different effect. Red makes them slide up and down vertically, blue has them sliding side to side horizontally, and yellow makes them move diagonally. You can also absorb and become the blocks themselves, allowing your character to move them around. You can also make slight adjustments once you replace them by holding down the Y button after you spit them back out. The further you progress into this one, the more stuff you can have your character absorb and inject into something else, or just simply absorb and use that object's inherent quality. For example, you can become this rock, jump from a high place, and you can smash whatever's beneath you. There's other helpers around too, like these guys who turn into springboards when they're injected red, walkers when they're injected blue, and jumpers when they're injected yellow. When these guys are involved, the game kind of turns into lemmings a little bit. That's just a small sample of your capabilities in Tsutehakun, but it gives you a general idea of what the game is like. There are 110 total levels in this game, so if you like puzzles like this, you're in luck because there's a lot of them here. There's even battle stages you can unlock, which are a one-on-one platforming race, kind of like the Gourmet Race in Kirby Superstar. What helps set Tsutehakun apart from other games like this is that there's no enemies. There are occasionally pits and spikes to contend with, but no enemies are bosses, so to speak, and subsequently there are no lives either. There's not even a time limit. Instead, there's a point system, where the points count down from 1,000 each time your character moves. In other words, the goal of this game is to get to the end of the stage, which would be the final rainbow shard thing, as efficiently as possible. So every little movement counts. But even if the points counter hits zero because you took too long, you can still finish the level. There's even a scorecard at the end of each stage, which is a nice touch. Let me just give a quick walkthrough example of what this game is like. That rainbow shard above me is where I need to get to, so let's grab this color red, pop down here and inject the block, ride it back up, take out the color and spit it out by pressing down, and re-inject it, ride it up and grab the shard. Hey, wait a second, the level didn't end. That means there's another rainbow shard somewhere. So you can hit the R button and take a look around the rest of the stage to see it. Flip the switch here to flip the jar color to blue, so we can bring this block over here to use it as a platform to jump up and get the last rainbow shard. Now, that's a pretty easy example, but I just wanted to provide something really straightforward so you can see what this game is like. And again, just like The Lost Vikings, some people may find this to be boring and tedious, and that's fine, but there's definitely an audience out there that enjoys these kinds of puzzles and trying to do them in as few steps as possible to get the highest possible score. And I know there's an audience out there for stuff like Tsutehakun because this game actually started on the Satellaview. There was a broadcast for 50 levels of this game back in 1997, and it was so popular that there was a cartridge version made exclusive for Nintendo Power subscribers. That's what I'm playing a ROM of here. Following that, there were three more Satellaview broadcasts of all new levels, so if you really like this game, there's plenty of levels out there for you to find. My only qualm with this game is that, like many puzzle games, it gets ridiculously difficult the further you progress. I don't mean just in terms of figuring out what to do or how to get there, it's that you have to be insanely precise with your jumps and block placement. Every single pixel counts. So while there may not be any enemies or a real time limit, this game can still make you tear your hair out. But if that doesn't bother you, or if you're just looking for a good challenge, then check out Tsutehakun. The puzzles are cleverly done and it's pretty easy to get the hang of things. This is an accessible game that anyone can get into, up until a certain point anyway. The best thing about this game is that there's a lot of it, with 110 levels and even more if you play the Satellaview ROMs. Unfortunately, the original Super Famicom cartridge goes for about $250 on average, but there are reproduction cartridges that go for $40 to $50 if you're into that. Or you can just throw the ROMs onto a flash cartridge and play it that way. Tsutehakun is one of the better games to have never been released outside of Japan, and if you like what you see here, go check it out.